Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, Lecture by Mr. Domine. Today I will going to show you like how you can run the program without having the same class name and the file name. It's a myth in Java programming that many people, they say to you that the class name and the file name should be same, but it's not mandatory. You can have a same class name and a file name, but because it's a standard practice, but it's not a mandatory. You can run the program even if your class name and file names are different. Today I will going to show you the same. I have already executed the code. Let me show you. This is the reverse code that I have executed, and you can see that my file name is emp.java and the class name is an example. So when I run this, it's already executed and giving an output. I will going to show you in front of this, and I can show you by running the program, as well as I will explain the program also. Before going to that, I want to show you something like in Java, it's usually many people they say that class name and the file name should be same, otherwise it will give an error. But it is not true. Even if you have a different class name and a different file name, then also it will run. Many people they prefer to have a same class name and file name because it is easy for the programmer to run, and it make the task of a programmer or developer easier. Because when you run on the Eclipse, you might have seen when you run on the Eclipse, it suggests you should have a class name and program name should be same, as I did here. You can see this is the class SBI, here is my class name and this is the file name. But it is not mandatory. Even if you have a different class name, then also it works. Like here I have declared the class SB and this is an SBI.java, right? So there is no error I'm getting. So similarly, I will going to show you, it's a myth that you should have a same class name and file name. Many video I've seen in the YouTube where they said that you should have a same class name and file name. It's somewhat true, but not exactly. It's not a mandatory that class name and file name should be same. Even if you have a different, you can run it. People, the developer or the like a programmer, they prefer to have, so they make their task easy. It make their task easy, but it is not mandatory. So here I will going to run one code and I will show you. I am using this virtual box where I have run this program. Here this is a reverse program where I am already read one value and I will going to print the reverse of it. So the logic I will explain you first, then I will run it and I will show you how the example means the class name and file name different, even then your program will run successfully. So first see the explanation of the code and then we can move into this. So here you can see here the number is actually your, the number that you are reading here is, just 1 minute. So here the number that you are reading here is nine eight seven six five four, right? You can see it here, this is the number. So let me explain you how it works. So suppose now when you initialize with the num, okay, so now you will going to check it, is num is not equal to zero. When this condition true, then only you will come inside. So how the flow is, when the condition inside the loop is true, you will come inside. So once you come inside, what you get it, you get remainder equal to the reverse it is. So the variable name is actually the reverse. So the variable name is here, actually reverse is there, this one you can see reverse. So what actually the, once you read this value, how the logic works. So first the remainder is, and then reverse, and the third is your number, right? So you have a three variable. How actually it works, let's start it. So once you read it, once this condition become true that your value is not equal to zero, you will come inside and I'm taking a shot RE for remainder, okay, as of now. So you can see num mod 10, mod is means it will give you the remainder. So when you divide it by 10, how much remainder it will give? 4, right? When you divide this 987654 by 10, it will give you remainder 4. Okay, now the next is your reverse. So I'm taking REV for reverse as a short. So whatever reverse current value is what? 0 now. Now the current value is 0. So 0 into 10 and plus your remainder. Actually, I have taken wrong here. This should be remainder. Okay, so when you plus remainder here, means this RE value here, how much you will get? You will get equal to 0 into 10, 0 plus 4. So now the reverse current value is 4. Now you will divide this number by 10. So as this number is integer type, so what value, usually when you divide it, okay, when you divide the number by 10, this 987654 divide by 10, it will give you 987654.4. And as it is in number is an integer, so it will pick the integer value, it will ignore the decimal, so it will be 98765. Now this 98765 will be pass it here as it is a loop. So this 9876 will be passed to here. Once now you will going to read it again, is this not equal to zero, condition true, you will come again, you will mod it by 10. So when you will mod it by 10, now this time when you mod it by 10, what value you will get it? When you divide it by 10, the what remainder you will get? 5, right? When you divide it by 10, 9876.5, that is your remainder will be 5, right? Then reverse into 10, what is the current value of reverse? 4, right? That you got in a previous step. So you will do here 4 into 10 plus current value of remainder 5. That is how much? I repeat once again, here 4 will come, the current that reverse value, previous reverse value, because the reverse is initialized with 4 last time. So what you will get it here, reverse 4 into 10, your previous value, plus current remainder is 5. So what will be the value? Your 45, right? So you got it 45. Now number is equal to number divided by 10. What was the number? When you divide it by 10, what you will get it? You will get 9876.5. Again, you will, just 1 minute. So we have done with here. Okay, now sorry, here when you divide it again, you will get 987.6. Last time when you divide it, you got 98765. When you divide it, you got 9876.5, right? So now when you divide it again, you will get 987.6. So as it is an integer, you will take 987, you will go back again and you will read it. So here okay, just 1 minute. 987654.5. Now here num is equal to num divided by 10, and yeah, here you will going to print also. So write whatever the reverse value you will get it, you will print it. So in first case, what value you will get it, you will going to print at the end. So now, till now we have solved it and we got a 45. Now number is equal to number divided by 10. So when you divide it, 98765 by 98765 by 10, you will get 9876, right? 9876 will go here. Is it equal to zero? No. You will come here, you will going to do mod. That is when you're going to do mod, you will get a 6. reverse into 10, what is the current value of reverse? 45, right? So here you will do 45 into 10 plus current value is 6, that is it will get 456. Now see here, you are in approach of getting the reverse value. So 456 you get, then you will divide the number by 10 again. So how much you will get? 987. Then again 987 will be not equal to 0. When you do mod, you will get remainder 7. Then current value is what? 456. So again you will get here 456 into 10 plus 7, that will give you 4567, right? So you are getting right 4567. Similarly, you need to do it for other two. And in this case, in this way, you will get 4567 and 89, right? How you're going to do that? Once you get 987, you will divide again, you will get 98. 98 is not equal to 0 here. Again, you will get remainder what? When you divide 98 by 10, you will get 8. 8 will be the remainder, right? When you multiply 4567 into 10 plus 8, it will be some, right? It will be something like this. 45670 plus 8, it will give you 45678, right? Similarly, you will get 9 at the end. When you divide 9 by 10, you will get 0.9. When you divide 98 by 10, you will get 9.8. You will ignore 8. You will go back again. Num mod 10, you will do remainder 9. Then you will multiply this again by 10. So I'm writing here the remaining of solution. 45678 into 10 plus remainder 9. So you will get 456780 plus 9. That it will give you 456789. So in this way, you will get. So once you get this solution, and now once you divide it, now 9, after doing that, 9 divided by 10, how much you will get? 9 divided by 10, you will get 0.9, right? So as an integer, it will take 0. 0 is equal to, 0 is not equal to 0, this condition become false. You will not come inside this loop and you will print the reverse value. So reverse value will be this. So in this way, we have solved how you can print the reverse of any number with the help of Java code. So in this Java code, I have explained you the logic, how you can convert the number into reverse, how you can find out the reverse of any number. Now let's see how you can run this code and having the different file name and class name. So here, you can see here in my code, this is the example, and this the class name of this file is example, and I have saved with emp.java. You can see it. If you are not visible, emp.java, I have saved this file. And the location of my file is in the desktop itself. If you want, I can show you in the desktop. So you can see this example.class file that is generated after running the file. Let me delete it. And this is my actual emp.java file. Let me open it. Once I open this, you can see emp.java, the class name is example here, right? If it is not showing, let me expand it. emp.java is my class name and is my file name. And the class name is this example. Now let me run it here. So now in order to compile this, what is the syntax? Java C. You will type Java C and you need to type file name. So what is the file name? emp.java. Now press enter. So see, there is no error in your program. That's why it's executed successfully. Now in order to execute or you run the code, you need a class name. So for that, syntax is Java and class name. What is the class name? You can see in the code, the class name is here, example, right? So let me do it. So I have just typed example. Now I will press enter. Now see here, right? So I have proved it, like, and I have shown you the myth is different, right? Means the myth that we have seen the class name and file name should be same is not true. It's not mandatory that you should have a same class name and file name. Here you can see the class name is example and file name is emp.java. You can follow the references here. I already knew it before that the class name and file name is not, should not be same, means it's not mandatory to have a same. If you have a same, you can try it, but it is not mandatory. Here you can see that these are the three references I have added in this file, in this paint file. You can refer these references in order to get more clarity on this. But whatever I explain you, I have explained you like the file name and class name should not be same. It's not mandatory. That it is a myth that class name and file name should be same. So I have shown you and I have proved you that even if you have a class name and file name different, you can run the code. If you like my video, then please subscribe it, share it, and comment it. Thank you.